Alafia, this is Ocarlie. Omochunlu sign over here in front of my Chango altar. Just to let you know a little bit of what the Orisha tradition is, the Cariocha, what people call the Santeria. Santeria is the worship of the Orishas. Each Orisha owns its own element. For instance, we got Chango's mysteries in this pot over here, Batea. Chango's element will be the fire, passion, luck. He is the great king. You have over here Osain. Osain is the deity of all the plants and herbs, which we will be giving classes about the herbs, and he plays a very important part, Osain, because he's the one that gives power and strength to those herbs that you're going to use to do spells and to do cleansings and to protect yourself against enemies and for prosperity, to keep getting ahead in life, opening your doors and stuff like that. You have Elegua, which this one belongs to my godson. Elegua. Elegua is the one that has the keys to open all the doors. Orlofi had granted that key to him. Because in one of the patakis, Elegua helped Orlofi and saved Orlofi when Orlofi was sick and nobody else could have done anything for him. And he granted Elegua always to be the first and the last to be taken care of in any ceremony of the Orishas. Like say we want to do a bow to Chango and feed Chango, we first have to come to Elegua, feed Elegua, give Ojen, which is a food sacrifice to Elegua, to open the roads and the doors to Chango and give us the right blessings for we could work with Chango and Chango could work with us. Obatala will be the Orisha. Let me see if I can do this. Obatala will be the Orisha of peace, purity, the king of the white claw. He lives in the highest of the mountains. Obatala is the king of all the heads. He's the only one that could safely be put on anybody, crowned on anybody's head. As we all know that each one of us is born with an Orisha. And that's when we have to find out which Orisha that is. And that's when you start doing the coronation, the crowning of the initiated priest. And if you put the wrong Orisha on the person's head, that is exobo. You can make the person go nuts, they'll do bad. So you gotta be very careful where you get your initiations done and make sure the person knows what they're doing. But Obatala is the only Orisha that could go on anybody's head with no problems. And the Orishas just will bow down and back away. He is like the father figure of all the Orishas. You have Ochun, which in that case is my crown. The one I have crowns on my head, Oshun Ibukule. Oshun Ibukule is one of the youngest Oshuns, and it's a very witchy of all the Oshuns. Ibukule, the Gole is the vulture. There's a Pataki that when she saved the world twice, the youngest Orisha, and saved the world twice. It came to a part day that there was a drought, there was no water coming down, so all the crops and plants and animals were dying because there was no water. So all the Orishas got together, Batala and all of them, and said, we gotta find a way to go to Orlofi and ask Orlofi to please bring down water so we could get food and everything here. All the land is falling apart without the water. So Batala tried, he couldn't do it. Didn't succeed. Chango, all the other older Orishas tried and couldn't do it. So Chun comes and says, Baba, excuse me, I will talk to Orlofi and I'm going to take care of this problem. The Orisha started laughing at her. Like, oh my God, you're the youngest. We're the oldest and we couldn't do it. What makes you think you could do it? Well, to make a long story short, Orchun gets into the vulture, the Kole, and goes up to Orlofi. and says, Father, we need your help. It's dry down there. We need water. Please, Father, we need water down there. And Luffy granted it. So she comes back down on the vulture. And before you know it, it started to rain. And all the Orishas were so shocked. Oh, thank you, Ochun. Thank you, Ochun. Oh, my God. Ochun, you did it. So after that day, it rained so much that all the Orishas got together and said, look, it's raining too much. We have to talk to Olofi to stop the rain for now. And then they actually went to Ochun and asked Ochun, can you please talk to our father for they can stop the rain? Too much water. Everything is drowning. And Ochun said, okay. Her laughing and smiling like always. Went right back up out with the vulture and spoke to Olofi, and Olofi calmed down the rain. That's how Ochun saved the world twice. When all the other Orishas couldn't do it, she did it. Okay, that's why Ochun is very important. Plays a very important role in the Orisha tradition. Ochun. Ochuni Bukole is a path for her that she walks in the muddy water. And she's very witchy. She's very witchy. She does powders and stuff through the pilons. That's my path of Ochun. Ochuni Bukole. And well, the basics of the Orishas in Lukumi tradition is to grab the four elekes, which is Chango, Batala, Ochun, Yemaya. And once you get the ceremony of elekes done, you receive your elegua and your warriors, which is Ogun, Elsun, and Elegua. Each person has their own personal path of elegua. In the Lukumi tradition, we look for the path of the person. Person's elegua to give it to him. That elegua will be the one that will go through all his priesthood and initiations and everything. The one that us, Oriateo, Iguoro, Iyalocha, Babalocha, Santeros give. This one right here. Okay. So after the elekes, which is the beads, you will receive your what's called the warriors. After the warriors, you will receive what's called Olokun. Olokun is the deity of the owner of the ocean. Olokun. Aganairi. Then you can receive the Ibejis. And then from there, you're already considered halfway asientado, halfway crowned. From there, you will go into your coronation, bring down your guardian angel, see who's your Orisha. And then you get crowned when you get the ceremony done to you. And you receive your Orishas. The Orisha tradition is beautiful. The drums we use to bring down the Orishas will be called the Bata drums, which is the set of three, which I have the set there, but I'll show you that in another clip. And you hear it playing in the background. That right now they singing to Ochun Sureyes. The Orisha tradition has to do a lot with the herbs, the animals, ebos. It's beautiful. It's more of a peaceful religion to keep you calm, healthy, with good luck, complete your life, and very beautiful, very beautiful. Now, in the Orisha tradition, don't get me wrong, if you have war, these Orishas are no joke, and especially with Osain that's over here, you will do some heavy spells to defend yourself and to alter things in your life. But the Orishas is more to do the good, to feel good, to get ahead, the strength, balance, and complete your life, a good, healthy life, prosperity and all. Each Orisha has an instrument or a tool that's used to call them down on. Like Obatala, you will use what's called Agogo. And you'll use this to call him down. That's the instrument to Obatala. Elegua will be with a maraca. Calling him down with the maraca. Should have one somewhere around here. I don't know where it's at. Yeah, and each Orisha has his element. Oya will be the Orisha of the cemetery. Agayu will be the power of the volcano. Ogun, his element will be iron. Ogun is my dad in Santo. Everybody's born with their crowning head, mother and father. In my case, it will be Ogun Arere is my father, and Ochumibukole is my mother, which I got crowned. I will be teaching the herbs of the Orishas. I'll show you some of the herbs of the Orishas. How to prepare them with the sureyes, songs that you use to give power to those ewe, the herbs, and how to work at least one spell with each Orisha, and as a priest, and spells that you could do as not a priest, or a priestess or whatnot. Well, that's basically it for now. Ache, alafia. Hope all is well. Bye.